Welcome students to my first lecture on thyristors. So these are the course contents which will be covered in my subsequent classes, online classes and lectures. So I will just brief you about the contents. So this covers introduction, symbol and construction, thyristor structure, characteristics, ideal switch, types of thyristors, static characteristics, effect of gate current on forward blocking voltage, four modes in thyristor operation, and the VI characteristics. So next we come to two transistor model, the thyristor turn on methods, types of gate triggering, switching characteristics, gate characteristics, thyristor protection, various protection techniques, selection of fuse for protecting SCR, the thyristor ratings, that means the voltage and current rating, improvement of thyristor characteristics, series and parallel operation of thyristors, their merits and demerits, applications, summary, etc. and followed by the references. So if we come to the layer diagram of thyristor, it is a four layer semiconductor device of alternate P and N arrangement. So it is a PNPN layer device. So here what we can see is, this is the symbolic representation of a SCR or a silicon controlled rectifier, and it belongs to the thyristor family. So the anode terminal, it is the positive terminal, the cathode is negative, and this is the gate. I have already told you in my previous classes that the gate is basically the lock of a door. Until and unless you open the key, that means the if you open the lock of the door, you cannot just go through the door or you cannot pass through the door. So basically it is the lock of the thyristor. This gate is the lock of the thyristor. So until and unless you open the lock, what will happen? Current cannot pass. So when the lock is open, the current will easily pass. So basically it has two states, one is the on state and the other is the off state. Next comes the trade name. This SCR, the trade name has been commercialized by General Electric Corporation in 1957. It is a four layer three terminal device. It has the highest power handling capability, and if we see the voltage and the current rating, we will see that the voltage rating is 1200 volt and the current rating is 1500 ampere. Now the switching frequency, that means it is an on-off switch. So what can be the switching frequency range? It varies from 1 kilohertz to 20 kilohertz. And what are the four states of operation? It is the forward conduction mode, the forward blocking mode, the reverse conduction mode and the reverse blocking mode. The word blocking means that no current will flow, and the conduction means that the current will flow. Okay, so this is the content of this particular slide. So now we move on to the next slide. So this is the detailed layer diagram of an SCR, and you can see it is alternating P and N layer arrangement. So it is a PNPN layer device, and if we see the junctions, it is a three junction device. So the number of junctions is equal to the number of layers minus one. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, for the ease of our analysis, we are going to develop a two transistor model of a thyristor. So how many layers are there? There are four layers, am I correct? So now if we see the four layers, and if we can split this four layers into two layers, and each of the layer is a PNP layer and the other is an NPN layer. So what is a PNP device? It is a transistor, and an NPN device is also a transistor. So one thyristor can be split into two number of transistor. One is the PNP transistor and another is the NPN transistor. So these are the dimensions of a thyristor. So what is the dimension over here? The unit is micrometer. So these are the dimension of the different layers of an SCR. And these signs, as I have already told you, these are basically the doping densities. These are the different doping densities of the layers, of each of the layers. So now, if I come to the VI characteristics, so as I have told you that there are four states. One is the forward conduction region. This is the forward conduction region. Now the forward blocking region, the reverse conduction region, and the reverse blocking region. So conduction means current is there, and the blocking means current is not there. Am I correct? So now, what is VF? VF is the forward voltage. That means a positive voltage with respect to the anode and cathode. A stands for anode and K stands for cathode. So VAK means that the positive voltage with respect to the anode and cathode, and it is known as the forward voltage. Because why forward voltage? Because when you apply the positive voltage, it will be forward biased, and when you just give that voltage and you give a positive gate voltage, what will happen? It will continue to block up to a certain voltage, which is known as the forward blocking voltage. So this particular voltage, I need to explain that, or we need to understand that what is basically this voltage. So up to this particular voltage, the gate current is zero. That means IG is equal to zero. So the gate current is zero up to this point. Now what happens? The moment some gate voltage is there, what will happen? Up to a particular value, after a particular value, you will see this particular transition, that after this particular transition, it will suddenly jump to this particular characteristics. And remember, my students, this particular transition will never be visible in the CRO. And this region is called the forward conduction region. So now, there are two terms over here. One is the holding current, that is IH, and another is the gate trigger current, IGT. That means it is the, this is the necessary value of the gate current to which the SCR will switch from the forward blocking region to forward conduction region. That is given by VGT. This is given by VGT. So this is the triggering gate voltage, and at this particular voltage, the thyristor will enter into the conduction mode. And what is IH? IH is basically the holding current. This is the holding current. So this is the value of the anode current below which the SCR switches from the forward conduction region to forward blocking region. That means the forward conduction region to the forward blocking region. So basically, this is the minimum value of current which is required to maintain the thyristor in the on state or the conduction state. Beyond this current, the thyristor will be blocking or it will turn off. Am I correct? So basically, you see, when the anode is positive at the potential VAK with respect to the cathode, with no voltage applied at the gate, the junctions J1 and J3 are forward biased, while the junction J2 is reverse biased. Now if VAK is increased beyond the forward breakdown voltage, the avalanche breakdown of J2 takes place and the thyristor starts conducting. If a positive voltage VG is applied at the gate terminal with respect to the cathode, the breakdown of the junction J2 occurs at a lower value of VAK. By selecting an appropriate value of VG, the thyristor can be switched into the on state suddenly. So it depends on the gate voltage how quickly the thyristor will come into on state. So this is my first lecture. Thank you.